Good evening, Grace Community. My name is Gwen Sampson, and I want to welcome you to our evening of prayer. Tonight, we're going to spend some time in prayer and using as a guideline the names of God. A name gives us identity, and there are hundreds of names of God, some of which he gave himself and some of which were given to him by others. In any case, we can be sure of this. God is who he says he is. He hears our prayers, and he will answer them in his time and in his way. Shortly, you'll see some suggestions on your screen for prayer requests, and they are suggestions. Please take the time to remember each other, the world, our nation, neighborhoods, and friends as the Holy Spirit leads you. Let's begin.
Jehovah Jireh, the Lord our provider. The Lord provided for Abraham long ago, and he continues to provide for us even today. Genesis chapter 22, verses 6 to 14. And Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it on Isaac his son. And he took in his hand the fire and the knife. So they went, both of them together. And Isaac said to his father Abraham, "My father." And he said, "Here I am, my son." He said, "Behold the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering?" Abraham said, "God will provide for himself the lamb for a burnt offering, my son." So they went, both of them together. When they came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built the altar there and laid the wood in order and bound Isaac his son and laid him on the altar on top of the wood. Then Abraham reached out his hand and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the angel of the Lord called to him from heaven and said, "Abraham, Abraham." And he said, "Here I am." He said, "Do not lay your hand on the boy or do anything to him. For now I know that you fear God, seeing you have not withheld your son, your only son, from me." And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him was a ram, caught in a thicket by his horns. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered it up as a burnt offering instead of his son. So Abraham called the name of that place, "The Lord will provide," as it is said to this day, "On the mount of the Lord it shall be provided." Romans chapter 5, verse 17. For if by the trespass of the one man death reigned through that one man, how much more will those who receive God's abundant provision of grace and of the gift of righteousness reign in life through the one man, Jesus Christ? Let us pray.
Jehovah Shalom, the Lord our peace. Shalom is about more than just the absence of conflict. It points to restoration, wholeness, and completion. Jesus is our peace, because it is through him the relationship between God and humans is fully and completely restored. Isaiah 26, verse 3. You will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you, because he trusts in you. John 14, 27. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. Let us pray.
The name of God, Jehovah Shammah, the Lord is here. Be encouraged. As God was present for Israel and dwelt among his people, he is here with us now. Psalm 139:1-12 ESV. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from afar. You search out my path and my lying down, and are acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, behold, O Lord, you know it altogether. You hem me in behind and before, and lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high. I cannot attain it. Where shall I go from your spirit? Or where shall I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there, your hand shall lead me and your right hand shall hold me. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me and the light about me be night, even the darkness is not dark to you. The night is bright as the day, for darkness is as light with you. Hebrews 13:5b-6 ESV. For he has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So we can confidently say, the Lord is my helper. I will not fear what man can do to me. Let us pray.
the name of God, the Good Shepherd. Jesus is the Good Shepherd who loves and cares for his flock so deeply he lays down his life for them. Isaiah 40, verse 11. He will tend to his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms. He will carry them in his bosom and gently lead those that are with young. Luke 15, verse 3 to 7. So he told them this parable. What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he has lost one of them, does not leave the 99 in the open country and go after the one that is lost until he finds it? And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders rejoicing. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and his neighbors, saying to them, "Rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep that is lost." Just so I tell you, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous persons who need no repentance. Let us pray.
Thank you for being with us this evening. Could I ask you to think on two things in the week ahead? First, would you think back on a name of God that meant something special to you this evening? And second, would you remember the prayer requests that were shared and continue to pray for them in the weeks ahead? Let's close in prayer. Father, thank you for being with us. Thank you for being who you say you are. Please take these prayers and requests and answer them as you will in your time and encourage us, your people. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.